In Iraq, a suicide bomber attacked a police convoy, killing 8 people, including a senior officer. The incident occurred in the city of Beji, the site of the nation's largest oil refinery, approximately 150 miles north of Baghdad. Government forces have been battling Islamic State extremists there for some time now. At least 32 others were killed today in a series of bombings in and around Baghdad. All this a day after President Obama announced plans to double the number of American military advisors in Iraq to about 3,000. For more, as part of our continuing interview series, The War on ISIS, we're joined now from Washington by Anthony Cordesman. He is with the Center for Strategic and International Studies and was the Director of Intelligence Assessment in the Office of the Secretary of Defense. I think the first question that a lot of people have on their minds is this mission creep? Why are we sending these additional troops in?
I think we need to understand what the mission really is. We have people on the ground to essentially rebuild the Iraqi army, create a Sunni force in the areas now occupied by the Islamic State, and help the Peshmerga become an effective military force. Now, we had about 1,400 people officially on the ground when this announcement was made. The actual numbers were higher, but not everybody was being counted. But that was scarcely enough to train 9 brigades of Iraqi forces. And the Iraqi army has to be rebuilt almost from the ground up. It wasn't enough to train an additional 3 Peshmerga brigades. And adding another 1,500 people certainly isn't going to be the end of this mission if we're successful and we can create Sunni units as well, which is essential to driving out the Islamic State. So it isn't a matter of mission creep. From the start, it's been clear the air campaign could only work if you could get political unity within Iraq and you could create a mix of Iraqi ground forces that could drive the Islamic State out.
So is there some confidence that either the U.S. or anyone else has that adding these 1,500 military trainers, ramping up, let's say, another 20,000 Iraqi troops in a few months will be enough?
We need to be very careful here. No, there is no confidence that this will be enough. First, it isn't a matter of months, although you can make progress with the better units in that time. It's been stated very clearly this could take several years. And for it to work, you have to convince the Sunnis in the western part of Iraq and in key areas in the north like Mosul that they will split with the Islamic State, that they will have their own military identity in these National Guard units. And those National Guard units are going to require a major U.S. effort to train and equip.
Was there a tipping point that forced this? Well, in the last few weeks, we've talked about several attacks getting closer and closer to the city of Baghdad.
No, not really. I mean, the fact that it can operate near Baghdad or Baghdad Airport has been a reality for months now. The tipping point is political. What's happened is that Maliki, who provoked a civil war, is gone. You have a prime minister who now has a minister of defense and a minister of interior. You have something approaching a national government. You now have the ability to put U.S. advisors in that can actually train Iraqi forces and help rebuild the army that Maliki helped destroy. And you have enough consensus to boost and support the Peshmerga forces. This is an ongoing political struggle. We don't know how it will come out. And as yet, the Sunnis, which are key to our success, have not, in any meaningful way, turned against the Islamic State.
While we've been focused on the troop movements and the increased presence of American troops in Iraq, what's been happening in Syria?
Well, we've suffered very serious reverses. Two of the key elements that we put training and arms into, the only really moderate elements in the northern part of Syria, have suffered serious defeats near the Turkish border by a different Islamist extremist group, the al-Nusra Front. We don't know how much equipment they've lost, how much military capability they've lost, but the units we did most to train and that were supposed to be the core of this force of free Syrian units that we were going to build up with 5,000 being trained in Saudi Arabia and another 5,000 trained elsewhere, have taken a very serious set of reverses. How bad that reverse is something which the Department of Defense couldn't estimate, at least as of yesterday.
All right, Anthony Cordesman joining us from Washington. Thanks so much.
A pleasure.